Yeah, why keep giving Panda shit, you know?
Yeah, like, I want to beat Panda.
And you know you're going to beat King with the freaking Rays, that's for sure.
Yeah, at least, well, like, yesterday, someone thought I was blowing the game. I was using two hots team.
Oh my goodness. Conflict of interest there.
Did you read?
Okay. Yeah, he's texting right now. Are you looking at your phone or?
Yeah, I see it. Maybe because of what I did to Gigi last night. I should just let the Rays lose, but I'll play it. I'll play hard because I'm just gonna practice.
You should have never wanted to use a Rays because that pisses me off too.
Yeah, I don't want to use the Rays, but I want to get.
And then this fucking guy disappears, and everybody's got a play that's good and win. How many
points
did you get with
them? With who?
Rays.
Did you use them? I haven't used them yet.
Oh, okay. Yeah, I wouldn't. You shouldn't.
I'll use them, because I'll just...
Yeah, you should be using the Rays, and you should be using the Cardinals.
You said conflict of interest, but I don't understand what's the conflict of interest.
It's a conflict of interest because... the Rays are in our division.
Whose division? Mine?
Isn't he in yours or is he in mine?
I don't know, but if he's in mine, wouldn't I want him to lose? So I should, like...
So that means you can make yourself lose.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying.
Yeah, I guess.
But I'm saying, like, if I'm the Rays, I want them to lose because they're... creeping up.
Alvarez crash in the outfield. Wow. King just got online now.
Yeah, he sent me Oh well, I'll play with the Rays. I am not, you know what? I'm not changing anything. Just leaving it how it is. And if I win, I win.
Yeah. Look where you keep pitching then. Well, you better look like getting them out of there, bro. Thank God this game don't matter to me.
Oh, he's in the East with the Rays.
Cool. King's in the East with him?
Yeah, but why wouldn't... So isn't that a conflict of interest if he's with the Rays? And you're in the Central with the Cards. So...
Yeah, you guys probably... You should have played this game against Freak.
I should have been the Cards because I'm doing...
And Anthony probably should have been playing with the Rays.
I guess King wants to try and beat the Rays.
He should be playing with the Rays.
Okay, whatever.
Because you're not. There's no conflict of interest. Like, we are. Like, me and Mondi, if we can't play for certain teams. You should. I'm
I'ma be okay. You say that you don't feel me now. I pull up, I'ma live somehow. Your love what? Never meant much to me. Love never meant much to me. Your love never meant much to me. Your love never meant much.
Born from the ether, I just appeared out of cloud. Scream invaded the world. Rick was coming out while you wriggling. I watch my mouth, child, he don't pronounce my name correct. Rules are gotta be rules, any exceptions, and I'm not a leader. Think in the box, and I get him, I fix the shot as if you get a donor hole, you'll get to the crib and quickly. I watch my mouth when I finish watching y'all suck clock. Don't doubt you put an ounce of that evil on me, I'm flipping Ricky. I give an inch to you simps, I'll never forgive me. No saying it's a conspiracy, but you're all against me. I see a future with runner tools, ain't the ever cancel my.
Said you're in the central with the cards.
Yeah. I don't get it, but whatever, I'll play it. I just want to play it and get it over with. Did you hear what I did to Gigi?
No.
10-3.
Every child, woman and man. Came back. It don't matter stick to your brain. If they judge. No, I'm saying he came back. He wasn't playing.
Oh. I guess not.
Break up his spirit.
Yo, he did that cheap shit to me in the beginning of the year, so I was like, I was waiting to get him back because I don't see him on the schedule.
Yeah.
And he had a two-run homer to start the game.
What, you got a three-game series with him? Oh, you could have got that, dude.
No, I was using Angels. I was playing for Too Hot. I'd rather beat Gigi. That guy's like my rival now.
That wasn't a two-run bomb. We would have tied the game. Oh. Damn. Don't circle against him because he makes you throw his ball. He's not that great of a pitcher. He'll throw where he can hit it.
Be patient against Freak. He'll throw some to you.
I know. That's what I was telling him. I said and he throws a lot. And he throws a lot of easy hittable pitches, man. And I have like 4 or 5 home runs against him.
And he gets discouraged easily. You could tell on his play when he gets down that he doesn't give a shit.
Yeah. Right. Yeah. He's a good player if he can fix a couple things.
You could tell like a bunch of the guys just don't have experience of being in the league for a number of games and.
Yeah, he's definitely one of them. If he was a seasoned player who's been in the league for many years, he would learn to have more of a poker face, you know? Like, don't show your opponent what's going on with you.
Yeah.
Don't show that that you're pissed off. I learned that the hard way, you know?
What's King saying?
What I mean? Should be glass though for this game. He said use glass though.
He's going all that. He wants me to go all out at him. He's not going to score.
I never used him before. I don't know how he is. Is he good?
Probably. All I need is like a guy that has
I don't even get to pitch with guys that have heat. Blue Jays have no guys. Everyone throws medium to soft to medium on the Jays.
Baseball from the gateway to the west, St. Louis, Missouri, and Bush. That would have been nice.
Yeah, I was trying to pitch that idea. King was about to do it, but St. Louis Cardinals. Stay tuned for Cardinals baseball.
Next. That's funny because I mentioned that before game. But I put it on idea. And he told me no. He shot it down. And stepping in, Wander Franco. I think maybe because he heard you, and then now he's like, oh, Jerry and Mondi brought it up. Maybe it is a good idea. I think maybe that's why he might have thought about it, you know? Entertain the thought of it.
Into the windup, here comes the 0-1. Game time temperature tonight, a comfortable 66 degrees at first pitch. From the windup,
yeah, that's the game. One
pitch.
Yeah.
All right, I'll let you lock in.
Okay.
Started to go. They'll look for the appeal down to third.
All right, bro. Have fun.
All right, cool.
Third base umpire. He's gone.
There.
Stepping up is Brandon Lau. Ready to deliver. Here comes the first pitch. One out. Nobody on. And this misses the outside corner, so it's knotted up at 1-1. A ball that's carrying. On the warning track, he makes the catch. So two out, nobody on. And here's Donaldson.
Josh Donaldson.
First pitch on its way. Two out, nobody on. A 1-1 count now to Donaldson.
That was a tempting pitch to swing at right there. A big power guy like this really wants something that he can elevate and drive out of the ballpark.
Slow roller, left side. Throw to first, beats him easily, and the side is retired. Into the box, Tommy Edman. He'll lead things off here in the bottom half of the first.
Way to go. Fourth hit, Blue. The second baseman, Tommy.
And the pitch. High and away on the first pitch fastball there. It's ball one. And it's fouled away. Now the 1-1 pitch. Ooh, he saws him off with that one. And that's the first out. So bases are empty with one out now. And into bat next, one of the fastest players in all of baseball, Harrison Bader. Ready to deliver. Here comes the first pitch. And here's a fastball called for strike one.
Hey, when you're featuring a mid-90s fastball like this pitcher, attack with that pitch. Get ahead. Get the offense on their toes. That opens up the off-speed pitches later in the game.
fouled off. Glasnow is a guy that's able to keep the bat off the ball. That's kind of the name of the game for a pitcher, and as a starter, it really helps him work deep into games.
Matty V, one of the toughest parts about scoring runs is bunching three or four hits together an inning. And that's one of the things this guy does really well. He's tough to hit, and he's really tough to get three or four hits off of. That's one of the reasons why he's one of the better pitchers.
Ready with the first pitch. Here it comes. Paul Goldschmidt stands in as he checks his swing here for strike one. A ball and a strike to the Cardinals' first baseman. Bases are empty here with two men out. Fooled him badly there. I mean badly. It's one and two. And he'll step out and ask for time. Maybe trying to get this pitcher out of the rhythm he's in right now. Tough curveball that time, but he's able to make a little contact to keep this at-bat going. Got him looking, and that ends the inning. Second inning set to go, and digging in is the outfielder, Austin Meadows.
The left fielder, Austin.
First offering on its way. Inside with the slider, and that'll back him up a bit. Two balls and no strikes to the Rays left fielder. Now the 2-0. It's offered at and missed for the first strike.
That is a pro pitch right there. 2-0 curveball for a strike. You make those kind of pitches, you'll be around for a long time.
Just a bit high with the fastball, but didn't get the call. And he fouls this one off. And a good sinker there gets him swinging for the first down. So one out and nobody aboard, and that'll bring up the versatile center fielder Manuel Margot. First offering. No score here as we play inning number two. Can't sit back long enough, and the count evens up at 1-1. Now the pitch. And a check swing here as he couldn't help himself, and it's ruled strike two. Fouled away. Did well just to make contact there as he spoils off a good changeup. Still looking for our first hit in the ballgame. Oh, don't know how you lay off that one, but he did, and it's 2-2.
This is exactly the reason why this guy has been so successful and has played this game so long, scrambling pitch after pitch, making this guy work out on the mound.
Bader is there now, and he has it, two gone. Two down, no one on base, and that brings up the corner infielder, G-Man Choi. First pitch of the AB now. And that's cut on and missed, 0-1. And it's fouled away. 0-2, here it comes. And they'll try to bounce a curveball on 0-2, but he holds back. It's 1-2 now. And he takes very close to the inside corner here. 2-2, though. Into the windup and the pitch. Breaking ball well inside and taken for ball three.
Boy, went from being in the driver's seat to now being in some trouble. Had the count 0-2, started nipping at the corners, and next thing you know, this count stands at 3-2.
Throw cleanly into first, and that ends the inning. Last half of the second set to go, and up next, the center fielder, A.J. Pollock.
The designated hitter, A.J.
Now the first pitch. Had him lunging at that one out of the zone, and that's strike one. And now before the 0-1 pitch, a quick stoppage as he steps out. And I'm not sure, but it looks like he may have been blindfolded for that swing. It's 0-2 now.
After that off-balance swing right there, you find yourself down 0-2 and wishing you were back on deck with the donut on your bat, visualizing hitting a home run.
Ready on 1-2. Fouled off. The next 1-2 pitch. Fly ball out toward left center field. On the move is Kiermaier. He's there and records the first down. So bases are empty with one gone. Waiting in to hit next will be Jake Cave. From the stretch, here's the pitch. And he takes a cold strike, 0-1. That fastball was a lively one. You could hear the pop of the glove all the way up here.
Hey, I admit I'm a little biased. There's nothing better than that pop of a glove on a good fastball. Looking forward to hearing a lot more of that pop the rest of this one.
And he'll try and tempt him with one in the dirt, but he'll hold back here. It's 1-2. A bouncer to the left side. Throw on the first will get him. Scored 5-3 on the putout, though it looked more like a 6-3 ground ball. Nevertheless, there are two away now.
Tyler. Oh,
the pitch. Tyler O'Neill is next as he finds himself behind 0-1. Oh, and he's really getting the better of him now. It's strike two.
You know that nasty changeup's lurking right here. If I'm in the batter's box, I have to count.
That will have to press pause as that strike three to retire the side. And that will bring in Yandy Diaz.
Leading off for Tampa Bay, the designated hitter.
And Yandy. Now the first pitch.
Diaz.
And he fouls this one off.
I love everything this pitcher's got working right now. He's got presence. He's got great body language on the mound. He's got fastball command and a nice early feel for his off-speed stuff.
1-1 the count. Now here's the pitch. Hit on the ground out to short. DeYoung gathers it in. Throw to first in time, and the leadoff man is gone to start the third. So one down, no one aboard, and that will bring in the catcher, Francisco Mejia. First pitch on the way. Swing and a liner. But this lands foul for the first strike. Pulled toward right center field. Long run for the right fielder, but it's the center fielder who gets there. And there are two gone now. Base is empty, two away, and that means Kevin Kiermaier will hit next. First delivery to him. And this is taken outside for ball one. Yank just fouled. Both teams so far yet to crack the hit column. And this one runs a little too far in, ball two. Well located changeup on that one as it catches the black for a called strike. The 2-2 is laid off, and the count runs full.
Well, he really needs to make this guy swing the bat right here. He's not the type of hitter you want to dance around with.
And a sinker called strike three as he's rung up and the side is retired. Bottom of the third now, and set to go is the third baseman, Kevin Biggio.
The third baseman, Kevin
First offering on its way. The 0-1 delivery. Off the plate, one ball, one strike. And now a curveball that's low and in the dirt for a ball. It's 2-1. Skied in the air to straightaway left. Meadows has it, and there's one away. Next to stand in is Yadier Molina. Ready to deliver. Here comes the first pitch. And that's taken high and outside for ball one. That evens it up 1-1. Now the pitch. Hit on the ground out to short. Reined in. And boy, just about overshot his man at first, but he's able to keep a foot on the bag over there, and that's out number two.
That's shortstop.
Paul DeYoung digs in next. This guy is still looking at a zero in the hit column. First offering. Just off the outside that time. Laid off for a ball. Out in front here is this one scorched. Foul to the left. Strike two, swinging just out in front of the slider. And now before the 1-2, time is called at home plate. Here's the pitch.
Those are the pitches in the game that you don't get back as an offensive player. I know it's easy sitting up here in the booth calling the game, but he'll be thinking about that one for a while if he doesn't get a hit in this at-bat right here.
Kiermaier will get there, and he puts it away to retire the side. So the lineup flips over, and digging in, Wander Franco looking to put the ball in play here. He went down on strikes in his first at-bat.
Still a big bagel in that hit column, and this is where the frustration can start setting in on a team if they're not careful. It's never a good feeling when you know the guy out there on the mound is completely shutting you down.
Fouled away. Here's the 1-1 delivery. Still all zeros in the run column here in the fourth inning. Dan, does this continue or does somebody score here?
I think this continues for a while, Matt. Both of these pitchers are throwing very well, throwing strikes, having good command of their off-speed pitches. This is going to be one of those low-scoring affairs.
O'Neill, a range to his left as he tracks this one down in left center for the first down. Now at the plate, Brandon Lau flew out last time up. Infield in the overshift here. Now the pitch hangs on him a bit that time as it's belted out toward deep center field. A ball that's carrying on the warning track. He makes the catch. So the bases are empty with two gone now, and that brings up the former American League MVP Josh Donaldson. And now the first pitch.
You're lucky if you get one pitch a night right down the middle. Cannot be late on that fastball.
Pulled high in the air out to left field. O'Neill waits on it. And that will end the inning. Ready to go for the last half of the inning, and that'll bring in Tommy Edman.
The second baseman, Tommy.
First pitch of the AB on its way, and it's fouled away. And this catches the inside corner. Good spot there. It's 0-2.
There's another pitch for a strike, and this guy's really attacking hitters well tonight, being aggressive early on. And if he continues to throw strikes like he is, he's going to have a pretty good night.
And a big cut at the breaking ball, but he comes up empty, and that's the first out. So that'll bring in Harrison Bader. He's 0 for 1 after grounding out in his only trip to the plate so far. He's set. Here it comes. Try to bunt for a base hit here as he gets this one down. But a foul ball here, 0-1. Fouled off. Pitching has the upper hand early as we're scoreless in inning number 4.
Hey, that fastball caught too much of the plate on an 0-2 count.
Nothing in 2 count and the pitch. And it's 1-2.
Love the high heater right there to raise the hitter's sights. Let's see if he buries something in the dirt right here.
Hit on the ground to short. Field it cleanly. Throw gets him. 2 down. Here's Paul Goldschmidt now.
Paul Goldschmidt.
First offering. And he fouls this one off. And that misses 1-1.
Yeah, that looked like a strike, but let me tell you, when you're staring at a big zero in the hit column, getting a call like that to go your way can feel like a big victory.
1-2 now. A swing and a miss as he chased with 2 strikes, and that will retire the side. Ready to go in the top of the 5th, and that'll bring up the outfielder, Austin Meadows. Infield shifted well to the right. Here's the first pitch. Good swing. Just got to try and straighten that one out.
This guy's been really on point so far, but it's not getting any easier. He has to get through 4, 5, and 6 right here.
Lifted the other way down the left field line. Chasing after it is O'Neill. That gets down, and the Rays' first hit of the game is going to be for extra bases. And the Rays strike quickly here in the inning. It's a leadoff double.
The batter, the right fielder.
And that'll bring up Manuel Margot. Swing and a ball hard hit toward deep right. And that finds the outfield grass for a base hit. G-Man Choi, the next to hit. As he'll take a look at a sinker here, too low for ball one.
Well, they've yet to hang a number on the scoreboard, but it looks like they've got a great opportunity from the breakthrough. Going to be pretty demoralizing if they can't.
2-0 now. Has a look, now the pitch. Is made. Here comes the runner from third. The run comes across to score, and they jump ahead 1-0. To the plate now is the designated hitter, Yandy Diaz. The potential second run of the inning stands at third. First pitch of the AB now. Broken bat as this ball's hit on the ground. And indeed, he'll take only the out at first as the run comes in to score.
The catcher,
now into the box, Francisco Mejia. He flew out in his last AB. Ready with the first pitch. Here it comes. There's a fastball well off the plate for a ball.
He's been great on the mound up until this inning. And yeah, he and his guys are behind 2-0 now. But if he can seal the lead.
Hot shot to first base and a great play to end the inning. Set now for the bottom of the 5th, and that'll bring up A.J. Pollock.
The designated hitter, A.J.
First pitch on its way.
This guy's been throwing the ball great so far, but it's going to be tested here. 4, 5, and 6 coming up this part of the lineup.
Now a check swing, but he holds up in time. Ball one.
Pitcher wants to have a quick inning right here, capitalize on the momentum his batters have.
well out in front of the breaking ball there for a strike. And now we'll take a moment here at home plate as he asks for time. Swing and a miss, and he'll start the fifth the same way he ended the fourth, with a punch out. One away.
Right field.
One out, base is empty, and it'll be the left-handed bat of Jake Cave digging in. This is hit high in the air out toward left center. Meadows will range to his left as he tracks this one down in left center for the second out of the inning. The next to bat for St. Louis, Tyler O'Neill, who went down on strikes in his last at bat.
Yeah, kind of shocked. He got blown away with a fastball. You could tell he was late on that one. And we'll see if he tries to cheat to something this AB.
One ball, no strikes to count. Here it comes, 1-0. And a strike to even the count, 1-1.
Hey, I don't blame him for giving up on that curveball. That was a rainbow coming out of the sky. Stole a strike.
That fastball's too much for him there. 1-2. Fouled away. A little low. It's 2-2.
I know he missed with a fastball right there, but this guy's arsenal. You can't figure out what he's trying to do. He's got a lot of different directions he could go in right here.
Full count, 3-2. Now the payoff pitch home. Swung on and missed, strike three. Standing in, Kevin Kiermaier. He'll start things out now in the top half of the sixth.
The center fielder.
And he'll start the inning with a pitch that misses off the plate. It's ball one. Right side, but it's well fouled. Lifted down the line and left. And he will make the catch on the full run. And there's a dandy of an out to start the inning.
Now back.
That brings up Wander Franco. First pitch of the AB on its way. Pulled toward right center field. Center fielder on the run. He tracks it down and makes the play to record the second out. Digging in will be Brendan Lau. It was a flyout for him in his last trip. First pitch on its way. Into the windup. Here comes the 0-1. And this ball's heading for the seats down the right side as the count will move to 0-2 now.
Hey, this is a huge at-bat right here. This pitcher wants to end this inning and have 3, 4, 5 due up to start the next inning.
Bader finds some space out there for the catch to retire the side. Bottom of the sixth inning now, and that'll give way to the third baseman, Kevin Biggio.
The third baseman, Kevin.
First pitch of the AB now. And he just keeps rolling along as he starts another batter out with strike one.
His slider's been impressive all night long. If he can continue spinning it like that, he's going to be just fine.
Count now a ball and a strike. Late on that one as it's fouled off to the left side. Here comes the 1-2. Is looked at for ball number two. He's caught looking at a beautiful curveball there as that buckled him for the first out of the inning.
The catcher.
Here's the catcher, Yadier Molina, comes into this at bat 0-for-1 in the ballgame. Swung on, but it's pulled foul wide of third. On its way, the 0-1 pitch. Oh, has him looking silly here. It's 0-2. And maybe trying to get him off stride at the plate so he'll step out and ask for time. Swing as he stays alive as this is fouled back right off the catcher's arm.
Can we be honest here? That was a terrible pitch. That was right over the heart of the plate. Two strikes on the guy. He is lucky he's getting this pitch back.
Ready on 0-2. Fastball just misses. That's ball one. Cardinals have been held out of the hit column here. And he struck him out. And that's eight strikeouts thus far. So two gone now in the St. Louis half of the sixth. And that'll bring in the Illinois State product, Paul DeJong. Started to go around, but it's ruled strike one anyway.
You know, over the course of a full season, you're going to have some clunkers, and this certainly looks like one. By the look on the manager's face, he's going to probably call a meeting after this.
A ball and a strike now. Here's the 1-1 delivery. And this one's up around the eyes, 2-1. No runs, no hits, and no errors so far for the Redbirds. A swing and a drive to center field. That one's got a chance. Kiermaier retreats to the track, and he'll put this one away. So a sigh of relief as the side is retired. Ready now is Josh Donaldson. He's 0-2 in the ballgame so far. First pitch on its way. No balls and one strike. Into the windup, here comes the 0-1. Ripped down the line. And there's a base hit, so maybe some insurance here to lead off the seventh.
Now battle. The left fielder, Austin Meadow.
Standing in now, Austin Meadows. Now here's a comebacker back to the mound. To second for one, on to first, and they get the double play. So base is empty now after the double play. And next to bat will be the outfielder, Manuel Margot. Now here's the first offering. Swing and a liner. But this will be pulled in out there at second base, and that'll be that. And now back to the leadoff spot in the St. Louis lineup. Stepping in, Tommy Edman. No hits in two trips to the plate for him in the ballgame. Now the first pitch. And it's fouled away. Set to deliver the 0-1. Breaking ball below the zone. That's ball one. Scooped up. Fouled off.
Hey, last two pitches back to back off speed. Then he's late on the fastball. He could pretty much do anything he wants right here on the mound.
And they'll try to get him fishing there, but he won't offer in the dirt, and it's back to even at 2-2. Drilled to first. And they'll step on first for the out, three unassisted. And that'll bring up the former top prospect, Harrison Bader. He was retired via the ground ball last time up.
Yeah, I understand that, Matty, but this guy's got burner wheels down the first baseline. I don't think he even concerns himself with that. He has to put it on the ground. That's part of what makes him successful.
And a fastball is in there for strike one.
Hey, the guy on the mound is absolutely pounding the zone, and that's why he's been able to stay and pitch deep into this game.
And he takes strike two. Now time granted here at the plate as he'll step out of the box. Lays off that time, and it's 1-2. And he'll try to get him fishing there, but he won't offer in the dirt, and it's back to even at 2-2.
He got ahead with two good fastballs and then tried to drop the changeup to see if he'd be out in front. Did a great job of laying off that pitch right there. Interested to see where he goes now.
Made a miss on the off-speed pitch that time. Harrison Bader becomes out number two this inning. Paul Goldschmidt started to go around, but it's a called strike, 0-1. And he fouls this one off. two out, nobody on. And now time granted here as he'll step out to rethink things down 0-2. And a check swing. Did he go around? No, says the first base umpire. It's ball one. Here comes the 1-2.
Hey, he's been able to pound that zone all night, working that outer half of the plate. That's why he's having so much success.
Now a fastball taken outside here as it moves it to 2-2 now. Check swing in the dirt, but he went around. And that ends the inning. At the plate now is G-Man Choi. He hit a sack fly earlier.
The first baseman, G-Man.
Ready to deliver. Here comes the first pitch. Popped him up. And Goldschmidt able to put the squeeze on it here. One away. To the plate now for the Rays is the DH, Yandy Diaz. Couple of ground outs on his batting line in two trips so far. First pitch on the way. And he lays off for ball one. Lifted in the air to center field. And this is taken in easily, and just like that, two are gone to start the eighth inning. Up next for the Rays, Francisco Mejia. He has flied and lined out in two trips in this one. First offering on its way. Tried to check it, and it's 0-1. Fouled away. Into the windup, here comes the 0-2 pitch. And look out as that fastball ran in and got him. Ouch, bang. So it's a runner at first with two men out, and that means Kevin Kiermaier will hit next. So they'll make a matchup move here and bring on a southpaw to face the left-handed hitter due up. First pitch on its way, and he lays off there 1-0.
When you've got a guy that throws a good two-seam fastball, you have to be ready for him to try to run it inside and jam you. Good job to lay off that one, but I wouldn't be surprised if we see it again.
And it's fouled away. Mejia, the runner at first with two gone. Boy, he just threw that fastball by him.
I think it's about time to choke up on that bat and get that foot down. He's awfully tardy right now.
A full count to the Rays center fielder.
3-2, two out, runner on first. Lots of possible outcomes on this pitch.
Now a changeup is bounced to second, reined in. He'll whip this one to first in time, and that ends the inning. It'll be the four-hole hitter, A.J. Pollock.
Meeting up for St. Louis, the designated hitter, A.J. Pollock.
He's set, and the pitch. First pitch of the inning misses here to the cleanup man. It's 1-0.
Every ball club has that spark plug guy, and this is the guy right here. He usually ignites a lot of productive innings.
On a great pitch there, caught in reach, and it's 1-1.
Something that stood out to me in this game is the lineup's lack of a solid plan at the plate. Seems like way too many guys are chasing pitches out of the zone and trying to hit pitchers like that one down and away. There's no success in that.
And he struck him out for the first out of the inning, but now perhaps more importantly, he's five outs away now. Now here's the pitch. Jake Cayer is in for a third plate appearance as he watches one miss inside. It's 1-0. Pitch on the way. Hit sharply on the ground. Base hit, and the perfect game comes to an end here in the eighth.
Now back, left field. Tyler.
At the plate now, Tyler O'Neill. This will take a look at a slider here that finds the zone for strike one. No hits to this point. Oh, got him to swing out of his shoes on that one. Nothing in two. And before the 0-2 pitch, he'll step out of the box here to regroup. Throw over to the bag and a dive, but he's back. The 0-2 pitch. Swing and a liner. But this is hauled in by the second baseman. Next, here is Kevin Biggio. He started out the evening 0 for 2 so far. He's ready. Here's the first pitch.
Not surprised he's laid on a heater right there. Just saw an off-speed pitch. Wanted to stay back a little bit too long.
Just off the outside that time, laid off for a ball. And this one's in the dirt. Runner holds as the count moves to 2-1. A runner on first with two away. 3-1.
If I'm in the box right now, I'm coming unglued. He is going to throw something over the heart of the plate.
Swing and a miss, and the count goes full 3-2. And now in advance of a big 3-2 pitch, time is called at the plate as he'll press the reset button. Fly ball right down the line in left. And Meadows makes the catch for out number three. Set to start the ninth in this one, and that'll bring up the switch hitting shortstop, Wander Franco. Now here it comes. Cabrera, 23 years old. He throws a four-seam fastball, a curve, a changeup, and a two-seam fastball. A little quick on that swing, and he finds himself behind 0-2. Fouled off. The next 0-2. High in the air out to center field.
What time is it?
Bader is right there, one down. So the next to bat will be Brendan Lau. It was a flyout for him in his last trip. First pitch coming, here it is. Swing and a miss on a ball inside, 0-1.
This is why you pay the price of admission right here. Power on power. My money's on the pitcher.
Into the corner and slicing foul.
You can really tell they're trying to keep the ball in on this big slugger right here.
Is that an effort to keep him from getting extended, do you think?
Yeah, I think that's the idea, Matt. But he might spin the win if he starts looking for it in there.
So it was a swinging strike three. Brendan Lau goes down for out number two in the top of the ninth. Sharp ground ball to third. A dive, but he can't knock it down. It's through for a base hit.
Now back, left field, Austin Meadows.
Into the box, Austin Meadows. And he fouls this one off. He's got a hit in three at-bats to this point. Swinging a hard liner to short. And that's in for his second hit of the afternoon.
The right fielder, number 13,
In now, Manuel Margot. As the first pitch here has been high, it's ball one. He's working on a 1-for-3 thus far. Off-speed pitch in the dirt as he takes it for a ball.
Hey, time to start making some quality pitches. He finds himself in a tough spot behind the count with guys on base.
2-1 after the foul ball there.
Hey, you guys know me. Hitting's a process of elimination, and I'm eliminating the changeup this next pitch. I'm on everything else.
3-1 now.
Hey, the bullpen needs to step up in this situation. I gotta believe the manager was hoping for way more than this.
Fouled away. Donaldson at second, Meadows at first, two out in the inning. Swing and a liner. And the inning will end as they're unable to cash in with two outs. All set for the bottom of the ninth. And now it'll be the catcher, Yadier Molina.
The catcher, Yadier.
Here's the first pitch to him. The 1-0 home. Check swing here, and they'll appeal it down to first, but Carl Dixon's right on it. He went around, so that's strike one. The 1-1 misses for the second ball.
I'd be real surprised if he goes back out away there on the mound. This is a count for a fastball challenge, and we'll see if he's ready for it in the box.
Left fielder is on the move. He gets there to make the play for the first out of the inning. So that brings in the power-hitting middle infielder, Paul DeJong. It was a flyout for him in his last trip. He comes set. Here's the nothing and nothing pitch. Now a drive by DeJong. This ball is hit well to left field. Now a leaping effort at the wall, but he comes up empty. This one is gone. Home run.
What a great feeling right there as he circles the pillows. Finally able to get this offense potentially going with one swing of the bat. Being shut out all game, but not anymore.
The batter number 19, second baseman, Tommy Edwin.
Now time is called as both guys in the bullpen are ready to go. Diego Castillo comes on here looking to get the final two outs and earn the save.
Number 63, Diego Castillo.
Lane Thomas will pinch hit here, and he's the potential tying run. First pitch of the AB now. Here's the 0-1. Easy take there on the sinker, well off the outside. Ground ball sent back up the middle. Fielded cleanly, and the off-balance throw beats him at first, and that's a tough play. Cardinals are down to their final out now. And in to bat next, one of the fastest players in all of baseball, Harrison Bader. Now here's the first offering.
That's a classic piece of pitching right there. You have to back hitters away from the plate to make them a little bit uncomfortable. Now you can go inside or outside. I like that purpose pitch.
High High fly ball out to straightaway center. Kiermaier on the run. Makes the catch, and that's the ball game. Close one tonight, 2-1 the final score. The Rays used a nice fifth inning to take the lead, and they never gave it back. Tyler Glasnow takes home the win. Dakota Hudson pitched well, allowing only two earned, but ends up taking the loss. So that's a wrap here tonight. For Mark DeRosa, Dan Plesac, and Heidi Watney, this is Matt Vasgersian. You've been watching MLB The Show. For more, find us.